Is that Chris?
Damn. See, when a lot of these dudes out here and they're in the streets and all that, they think about themselves, but this is what they don't think about. They don't think about who they may affect, such as their parents, their sisters, their little brothers, and their family, not even knowing that you passing away is going to be even tougher on them than you think. And it's going to make their life worse because they got to deal with that, bro. Especially when it's in a manner like this. But the way his mom responded, I ain't going to lie. You got to take your hat off to her because she just kept it real. Man, what is good, YouTube? Y'all already know who it is, bro. It's Lucas J here, y'all. Back up with another video, man. And today, y'all, we got a crazy and wild video to talk about. Now, it seems like in today's classroom, y'all, we got Fulio Mom on the roster. Yes, y'all, we got Jacksonville long ago rapper Fulio Mom on the roster, and she responded to his passing, and she pretty much spoke on and sent everybody a message that was saying, like, oh, it starts at home, and where was his mom at the whole time? He was dissing, and the way she explained it, you could tell she was not lying, but at the end of the day, people gonna do what they want to do. Now, before we get into this crazy video, y'all know my routine real quick. Hit that like button, you feel me, and smash that bell so that you know I can keep y'all updated on this situation, and y'all can be notified anytime I drop a video in general, period. Now, as I said, man, we got Fulio Mom on the roster, and she responded to his passing. Now, obviously, we all know 3 days ago, he lost his life after being shot and killed while celebrating his birthday. On the 23rd of January, now y'all know Fulio was known for dissing 23, which is Young and Ace homie, and you know, things turned out bad for him. You know, he lost his life. You know, he made his bed, he laid in it. Sad situation, but his life. You know what I'm saying? Rest in peace to Fulio. Now, everything that people were saying ever since he passed away was, oh, he deserved it, and oh, he had it coming, but oh, where was his mom at during this whole time? And oh, his mom gotta play a role because it all starts at home. Now she responded, and first she put up this video.
Love money.
Yo, yo, what's up? We in the studio. Tell the name of y'all group.
After she put up that video, you know, as you seen, a little boy, you know what I'm saying, that when it grew into a man, she put up the caption and said, RP son, Charles Jones II, Fulio, the real life story documentary coming soon. The story that only I could tell because I know the truth from the face. I think I'm the only mother that kept it real while most others know dang well what was going on with their own sons. This been going on since 2014 through 2015. Some of these women celebrating your death is some of the women that looked up to me sitting in my building. I was their teacher and they were my students at a big grown age taking notes. Let's not forget that. The same woman that was buying your CDs for their kids. Let's not forget that. These same women's sons did the same thing you did, went tit for tat on this drill music, in which I never condoned. Mother ever asked, what was his mom's? It start from home. Them not knowing, I stayed on you about this beat-ish. Cussed you out, begged you to take stuff down, and when I was shot 8 times, I spared their lives, even though moms was changed. 10 years ago, you started this music stuff in Jax, Florida, had all the teen parties turned, caught mega bus to Atlanta at 16 of your career. I think your first interview was with DJ Small Eye, but I'll talk about this later in the documentary. I do want to thank those who believed in him at the age of 17 when he moved to Atlanta. He tagged somebody, Zaytoven, especially Young Thug, and others who had an impact on his career. The untold story only I could tell coming soon. Special thanks to Mark Leon Jr. Create Music. So much unreleased coming soon. Now, as y'all see, you know, she responded and said, you know, the same people that's making fun of him were the same people that was in her class. And, you know, because if y'all don't know, she's a doctor, or she's a nurse, if I'm mistaken. And they were saying that they were taking notes from him, and the same people and the same mother that's celebrating were the same one that he was buying, that she was buying, that they were buying CDs from him. Because like I told y'all, I did my research on Fulio. Fulio been rapping since like 2012, you feel me? He's been known in Jacksonville, you know what I'm saying? He's been a known face, like I said, though. But the beef and stuff been going on. As you said, she said 2014, 2015, he got shot coming off the bus while he was coming from school. Literally, you feel me, back in the day. So that should let you know he's been around for a while. You know, she said she got on to him, which I assume, I doubt she was praising it, especially if y'all didn't know she got hit 8 times. You know, thank God she survived, but kind of his BS. So obviously, you know, she feels type of way. But at the end of the day, I tell people this all the time, I'm like 50-50 when they come to it start at home, because it do But I feel like when it's a dude, it's kind of different, because a male, once he get to a certain age, and y'all know, if you're a male, you know, it's on, like, nobody really can tell you now. Like, when you become a male and you get to that mature stage, you kind of, even though your parents there, you choose to listen to them, and obviously, we all got free will. But they get to a certain point, when the man got his mind made up, I didn't really know you could tell him. He got to learn from his own mistakes. And that's a sad part, because I know she probably saw this happening down the line, and she didn't want this to happen, but she knew that if he didn't stop, you know, it could. And it's crazy. He moved to Atlanta, and he still somehow got his stuff involved and stuff. You know, it's just a sad situation. Now, I want to start out by saying, my last video I spoke on Fulio, and I said something like, F Fulio, and I wasn't trying to be rude. When I said it, people took me as I was saying F Fulio, like him. No, I was saying F the character, F the persona, F the rapper image. I'm talking about Charles Jones when I was spending that. But the way I said it, it kind of bothered me when I went to sleep, and it was like actually messed with my mind, because I don't want to come off as if I don't like him or I had a problem with him. I don't know him, you know. Rest in peace to dude. So, you know, at the end of the day, a mother is burying her son, and I just want to say, you know, I apologize for that. I definitely didn't mean to say it in that way. Because I know that could offend somebody and that could hurt somebody. Because I don't, like, regardless of what he did, obviously we know he wasn't no angel. His ops weren't either. He did just like they did. You know, he kind of took it to a stream a couple times. But it is what it is. I don't pick faces. I don't, you know what I'm saying? I don't wish that on him. I wish that wouldn't have happened to him. I wish things would have went different. But I kind of figured out, and I knew it was going to go that way. You feel me? It's just unfortunate situation. But y'all let me know what y'all think, bro. And let me know how y'all feel about this. And let me know, you know, a lot of parents should start being more open like her and start being truthful, because a lot of y'all sons out here is thugging and y'all don't know it, and y'all think they just such an innocent baby when they die. Oh, he played football, this and that, and the whole time he was the Grim Reaper. So I respect that, you know, obviously he can let his mama know what was going on. Obviously she knew what he was into. She can't make him do nothing he don't want to do, and she took it to the chin, you know. But I do want to see the documentary, because everything stemmed from something, so I would love to see that. But y'all let me know how y'all feel about this in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think, bro. Y'all already know who it is. It's Lucas J. Thank God for another day. May y'all be safe. I love y'all. Christ loves y'all so much more, man. And yeah, bro. I'm out, man.